I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Nina Zakharenko.
And this is five things that you didn't know that Python could do.
That's right. Here's a freebie. Did you know that Python is 28 years old?
Really? Did you know that I'm 28 years old? That's a fat lie. Thing number one, Python empowers scientists. How does that work?
There's a scientific base in Antarctica called Concordia Station, and the scientists there use Python for a lot of their analysis, graphing, data collection. They used it for a cool experiment where they drilled down 2 miles into the Earth to analyze air that's trapped under the ice from
the
a million years ago. Yeah.
You think they would go up to get air, but no, you have to go down to get
down.
Air, apparently.
Yeah, really old air.
Really old air, that's what you need. So what else can you do with, how else does it empower scientists?
Yeah, so scientists use a ton of the available AI and ML tools in Python. There's SciPy, Pandas, PyTorch, lots of other things. And then on Azure, you can use hosted Jupyter notebooks. They're called Azure notebooks, and they're really cool.
Shameless plug.
Yeah.
I know a couple things about Python. Did you know that a Python can eat your whole body in one bite?
That's not true, Burke.
It's true. Also, other facts about Python, it's the second fastest land animal.
That is also not true.
It says so right here.
Those are Burke facts, not real facts.
It's on the internet, so it's true. Thing number two, Python is used to create a lot of video games and art that you probably use or have seen before.
Yeah. So I think the most famous example here is EVE Online. It's a massive multiplayer game with, at some point they had, you know, 100,000 users, or players rather, and they use a variant of Python called Stackless Python, and that allowed them to iterate on their game very quickly.
There's also a potato game built with Python?
Yeah, so there's a game called Super Potato Bra, and you can find that, you can find that on Steam. So it's a game that was written entirely in Python, and the premise of it, it's a platformer. So you're a baked potato, and you're trying to save all of your vegetable friends from an evil ladle that wants to kidnap them and turn them into soup.
Sounds so exciting. I'm trying to think of a good potato joke here, but I don't really have one. Potato jokes have to come naturally, you know?
Yeah.
You can't russet. Thing number three. You can do home automation with Python. So there's a lot of home automation things. I use the Amazon Echo.
Yeah.
What can you do with Python?
So there's a Python package called Home Assistant, and it's a really popular home automation library. And you can use that to make a home automation system that focuses on security and privacy first.
Ah.
Important.
Are you saying that me talking to my home assistant isn't private? I tell Alexa all my darkest secrets. I just sit and talk to it.
Oh boy.
It's not good.
Yeah, you can run it on a Raspberry Pi at home.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And then it's all contained inside the walls of your house.
Right, and you can connect your IoT vacuum cleaner and your IoT light bulbs and your IoT rice cooker.
You know, all that stuff would be funny if it wasn't true that I actually owned an IoT vacuum cleaner.
Did you?
Like, we have reached peak 2019 already.
Oh man, Burke.
Sinus.
Yeah.
All right, do you want a Goo Goo Cluster?
Yeah.
This is the original. It's got peanut, caramel, marshmallow, nougat, and Python.
Is this your favorite?
It's everybody's favorite. It's so delicious.
Oh, it's very messy.
It is very messy.
Mm-hmm.
Also, there's like 10,000 calories in one of those, so you don't need to eat again. But much like a snake, you're good for a month. Thing number four, scaling. Python scales, and how do we know that?
Well, Instagram runs Django, which is a Python web framework, and Instagram has 1 billion users.
Yeah. There's a few people that use Instagram.
Yeah.
I am not one of them, by the way, but I've heard of it. Aw, there's a pug playing with a football.
It's a puppy.
Oh yeah, there's another one. I follow a lot of pug accounts.
Oh.
Oh, that pug has its own pug, like a pet pug.
That's really
cute.
Pug.
A pug has a pug. I've heard of it before. Yeah. All the kids are using it. Also, there's Reddit and...
Yeah, Reddit and Quora are
Quora.
Both Python-based. Dropbox is also Python-based. Guido Van Rossum, Python's creator, has worked there for a few years now. And then Read the Docs, Write the Docs. Everybody loves docs. That's a very popular Python package that is hosted on Azure.
Do you know there's only two kinds of documentation?
What are they?
It's the kind people don't read and the kind they complain about. Thing number five, hardware. You can run Python on hardware.
That's right.
That'd be like 2x4s and hammers.
Yeah.
It's a weird place to put
nails.
Python.
Yeah, nails. Weird stuff. So there's two subsets of Python called MicroPython and CircuitPython.
Okay.
And then there are lots of hardware platforms out there. My favorites come from Adafruit. So this right here is a Circuit Playground Express. This runs Python, and it's got a lot of stuff on it. It's got LEDs, it's got light sensors, temperature sensors, buttons, switches, kind of everything that you need to get started with a hardware project without having to solder.
Nice. Were you telling the BBC gave something like this to every child?
Yeah. So the BBC gave away something called a micro bit that runs MicroPython to every child of a certain age in the UK. So the fun thing about this particular device is if you don't know Python and maybe you don't know how to program, there's something out there called Microsoft Make Code.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that allows you to program this with just a drag and drop interface.
Oh, nice. And how much do those go for?
I want to say this is $30 or $35.
Not bad.
Yeah.
I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Nina Zakharenko.
And that's five things that you didn't know that Python could do.